Ellie is the second eldest in the family amongst us six siblings, so I don't remember her as a child growing up. But I will use Mommy's words in describing Ellie as a little girl. Mommy said that if you put Ellie in a carriage early in the morning, you would find her in the same spot at midday. She would just sit quietly for hours, not even crying. That's how good she was. I remember as a little girl, we took a European trip. And I think Ellie was 17 at the time. Mommy had planned on having her spend her 18th birthday in Switzerland. But we almost cut short the trip early on because Ellie was always sick, feeling like vomiting and having fever all the time. That's why I think it was heaven sent that she married a doctor in Lewy who is taking good care of her up to now. Ellie was brilliant in math and in numbers. When others chose to take up less challenging courses, Ellie opted to take up chemical engineering and being a member of the Honor Society and passing the bar with flying colors. But it was cut short when she got married and had to accompany Lewy to Oxford, England for his master's studies. And that's where Ellie took up courses in information technology, which I think was responsible in making it her career when she came back from England. She headed the successful unification of the Manila and Makati Stock Exchange, and she did it with flying, also again with flying colors. Later on, she opted to a more quiet role as a well-respected professor in the Ateneo Master's College, and Father Cruz, in fact, was instrumental in giving her a doctorate in information technology. She was in charge of the courses of executives and management trainees. Ellie is an ideal sister, a very helpful one. I don't think I would have passed my sewing classes if Ellie did not help me in all my sewing projects. She is also an ideal doctor's wife, always being around to help anyone who would call up Lewy for medical assistance or to help in a broken knee or in anything, to a point where she memorized all the prescriptions and would even contradict Lewy when Lewy was giving a prescription. And she would say, "No, Papa, that's not the one." And Lewy would just laugh and say, "Okay, Doctora Pasion." Ellie also had a stint in modeling with Christian Espiritu and many others because she had beautiful legs and was known at that time as the Nancy Kwan of her generation, being with a Chinese mestiza with beautiful legs and very nice figure. She also played basketball, unknown to many, which was her favorite sport in high school. Today, Ellie has retired and is a full grandmother to her children and grandchildren, taking care of the family and accompanying Lewy in his many trips abroad as a head of the orthopedic a society of the whole Southeast Asia.
Well, my fondest memory of you is when you helped me enter Mapua coming from Adamson. And it was really a challenge to enter a school of engineering. Anyway, I finished it and good. It helped me where I am now.
So I would say about 5-6 years ago, I was in the Palms Country Club and I was entering the gym. I wanted to get fit, you know, exercise. And as I was approaching the treadmill area, I saw this lady, very poised, walking. The reason why she caught my attention was because she was in full, you know, casual attire and with pearls and all the jewelry. So I was curious, and then I walked a bit, and then I noticed, I think this person looks familiar from the side and from the back. And then when I made pasimple to look further, lo and behold, it was Tita Ellie doing her treadmill like that, walking and looking up like this, very poised and very, you know, full of finesse. And it put a smile to my face, because that's Tita Ellie for you, no? Even sa exercise, mind you, in the treadmill, walang pawis, poised, fully decked out with the jewelry, pearls, necklace, and earrings galore. So I just found that very funny, and I wanted to share that with all of you.
So, my fondest memory of Tita Ellie is that growing up, we would always sleep in her house, and she would always be very welcoming, making sure that we had everything we needed. That's why summers were always fun when we slept over.
Happy birthday, Tita Ellie. I always remember Tita Ellie as a kind, intelligent person. My dad would always talk about her and say that her and my dad were both engineers, and that's why probably they never fought really in their life. I always remember the many Christmases and the many New Year celebrations where Tita Ellie would always host the dinners along with the Pashuan family. And she'd always ask if we've eaten, if we're hungry, if we need anything. She always never fails to mention if we need anything. I always remember Tita Ellie as a very kind person. So
happy birthday, Tita! One of my fondest memories of you would probably be every time you guys would visit Diliman, Teacher's Village, your colorful clothes, and every time you play Mahjong, you'd always compute so many points, or I'm not sure what you call those, but you'd always compute so many points every time you play Mahjong with sila mom and dad. And I always hear that you're such a strict teacher or professor in college, but I just couldn't imagine, no? Because you're always so gentle and kind and refined. So I just can't imagine a strict version of you.
My fondest memory was just growing up and spending the holidays, especially New Year's, in their house. And I remember just overall, you know, creating a lot of those memories and just having a good time with the family, with the cousins. And Tita Ellie always telling us that we have to eat 13 grapes and jump so that we would all grow tall, even if it didn't work for me.
Fondest memory. My fondest memory of Tita Ellie. I just remember when we were kids, I always see her with Tita Litz. So the whole time, I always thought Tita Litz was her mom. And then I always remember she always had colorful shoes that they used to call zapatilla, something like that, or like our slides nowadays. But yeah, I know she always loved these, you know, open toe, really cute slides. That's what I associate with her. And then fondest memory, I remember going home and when the first time we brought home the kids in, I think it was 2017, and then she just said, "Oh, Iha, come here. We have a dinner for you. Let's have dinner." You know, just them there, the Pashons and us. And I thought it was a small one. And I'm like, "Okay, Tita, we'll pass by." And when I got there, she had this, like, all this food and invited all these cousins, other cousins. It was like a, you know, reunion party. And that was, we were so touched. It was so very sweet of her. So that was my latest. There's a lot of fond memories, but that's one of the latest ones. And then some of the times when she would visit me here in the States, you know, and then I would see her and Tita Lewi, it was always nice to see them. She always reminded me of back home.
One advice that out of the many that I remember was before getting married, you said to me, "Iha, leave a little mystery with your husband. Don't show yourself at your worst. Don't show him na naka-rollers ka. Kailangan medyo ayos. Don't share the same bathroom at the same time." So through the years, it helped me with my marriage. Medyo napasobra nga lang, tita. Kasi we now have separate bathrooms. Anyway, thank you for all the advices. Alam mo si Tita Ellie, pag nag-advise, titignan mo siya, di ba? Ang ganda. Tapos ang pleasant. Tapos ang fashionable. I like the way she matches her colors. Tapos pag nakinig ka, parang angelic yung voice. So alam mo, kailangan mo talaga makinig kasi kung hindi, di ka pupunta sa langit eh.
Three things when I think of Ninang Ellie. First, she's always smiling when she greets you. It's one of the things I always, when I think of her, she's that person that when you see her, she looks at you, she smiles, she asks how you are, and she doesn't rush that moment. Obviously, even if there's a lot of grandchildren or, you know, cousins and family around to greet, she's always, you know, takes the time to look at you, smile, and say hello, how are things. Second is the connectedness with family. I always think of her as someone who tells, you know, shorter stories than the usual Chrysostomo sisters who take a longer time. She always tells, you know, short, you know, stories that you remember, like my dad, or, you know, about Eric when he was young, or with the cousins, or how we used to be rowdy and all the things we did, all the naughty things we did when we were young. And then third is, my favorite thing is when we were always at the Pashons, she would always ask, "What do you want to eat, or are you hungry?" And that was one of the fondest memories growing up, is every time we'd celebrate there, she'd say, "Are you hungry?" And of course, the answer is always yes. So,
whenever I see Tita Ellie, she's very gentle. Like, whenever I hug her, she's just very gentle, and she always has a smile on her face, and she's always well dressed.
Tita Ellie really gives this warm and welcoming vibe, and it's very, very easy to feel comfortable around her.
I think I'm cute. I know I'm sexy. I've got the look. The drives are going wild. I've got the mood. That really move her. I sense you. Up and down their spine. I'm just a sexy boy. I'm not your boy toy.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white.
Goodbye, but the dawn is breaking, it's early morning. blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could die. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. Sing for you when I come back out.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road.
Surprise! Good afternoon. Hello there, my forever dearest love of my life, Ellie. As you embark on this incredible milestone of turning 80, I can't help but reflect on the amazing journey we have shared for the past 54 years. You have always been my rock, the light, my inspiration, my confidant, and the only love of my life. Before I begin, I would like to thank Melissa, Richie, Ed and Eric, and of course, Art, Rice, and Trina for organizing the surprise birthday party for you. You children have all been our best blessings from God. Now, Ellie, my love, you listen to this. I have many things to thank you for. First, for having chosen me to be your husband 54 years ago. You didn't make a mistake, or did you? I hope not. Otherwise, you would have not celebrated this special day at all if you didn't tie the knot on that morning of April 11, 1970 at the Santuario de San Jose in Green Hills and signed our covenant of marriage. Covenant, I would say, because it meant forever. Also, thank you for taking care of our four children, showering them with the love, affection, the discipline only a mother can give, and together with me in guiding them to become the successful professionals that they are now. Thank you also for having been my inspiration, my supporter, moral booster in all my undertakings in life, the wind behind my wings, as I will always say. For being with me in most of my foreign trips to international orthopedic meetings and thereby making friends with my orthopedic colleagues and their wives. As a matter of fact, you have always been very active and enthusiastic in organizing and leading the ladies' committees of not only the local but also the regional and international orthopedic associations that I have been a leader of. I'm really so proud of you, my love, for doing this. For calming me down whenever I lose my temper in some rare occasions. That's the bull temperament of a Taurus born. I'm sorry for the times that I made you sad because of my stubbornness. But of course, I always made it a point. Before I slept, I always said, I'm sorry, I love you so much, and good night. Then greeting you in the morning with a sweet good morning, I love you, when we woke up in the morning. Thank you for always being there for my breakfast for the past 54 years. I thank the Lord Almighty for giving you a lease in life. Actually, a second life. After you survived that life-threatening aortic aneurysm surgery 7 years ago. I'm really so happy that you survived that. Now that we are in our eighth decade of our lives, let's continue to live it even better, even sweeter, even lovelier and romantic. I always hope and pray that God Almighty will give us many more happy and healthy years to live, for us to see our grandchildren grow up as successful professionals.
Three words to describe you, Ellie. You're beautiful, intelligent, and beautiful, intelligent, and resourceful, very resourceful. Actually, for me, parang you seem to know everything. Kaya, idol din kita.
Classy, beautiful,
and thoughtful.
Warm, sweet, loving. That's always what she makes me feel. I always feel loved around her. She's always so sweet. And there's just a certain amount of gentleness when you're around her that just really makes you feel home or loved, or you know, just it's just nice to be around.
Poised, reserved, gentle.
Ellie. So the first is that she's extremely intelligent. The second is I remember when I was really young and my mom used to show me all of their old pictures before, and I used to tell this to my mom all the time, but I remember just being completely in awe because Tita Ellie is just so beautiful. And the last is of course her smile. You know, every time you see her, every time you greet her, she's just always smiling.
Very sweet, streak number one, sweet at saka medyo malapit ni Chucky. Airpods, one of the favorite kasi ni Papa yan si Tita Ellie. At one point nga may nalaman pa ako na-meet ko yung isang guy also from Sanlo. Tapos ang tago na lang natin siya sa pangalan, Almazora. Ngayon, nung nasabi ko sa kanya, "Sir, matagal na ho ba kayo dito sa Sanlo?" Sabi niya, "Oo. Sir, may mga relatives po ako dyan, mga Crisosto." "Ah, meron akong mga dinate dyan. Double date pa tayo," sabi niya. Tapos, may kasama silang laging lalaki. Tapos sabi ko, "Sir, pangalan mo ba ng lalaki? Boy?" "Yun," sabi niya, "oo. O, yun sir yung dad ko, yung boy. Ngayon, si Tita Ellie, may kasama nga. Tago na lang natin sa pangalang Elsa." So may double date sila. Ang gamit nilang rason, si AirPods, lalabas sila. At driver bodyguard si AirPods that time. So may mga escapades din pala yung mga tita natin.
Well, growing up, we're very fortunate to have a mom such as you. Most of the things that I know of being domesticated and everything has really been because of your training when you were growing up, you know, from the cooking to the cleaning to the fixing of the house. And those are the things that I try to teach Lucas as he's getting older. You know? In fact, here in Europe, Lucas started cooking already. For us, cooking bacon, eggs, and hot dogs, and hopefully everything, the values and everything that you've given us or taught us, I will be able to pass on.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best.
Happy birthday, Ellie, to the Miss Beauty and Brains of MIT Philippines. Hi, Ninang Ellie. I still remember when JJ and I used to follow you around. Wishing you the best today and every day.
Happy 80th, Tita Ellie! Just 20 more years before your centennial benefit at SSS!
May you never run out of reasons to smile, Ninang Ellie, from your ring bearer.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday, Tita Ellie! Maligayang bate sa iyong kaarawan, Kumaring Ellie. Since 1976, when you and Levi accepted to be godparents to our daughter Lauren, we have happily shared our true friendship and in many affairs. Your earnest sincerity in your relationship with your family, relatives, in-laws, and friends define your person. Your zeal in guiding your children in growing up, including in their education, is very admirable. Your expressive trust on your loving husband, Levi, as well as your strong support, helped lead him to many honorable achievements. Kumare, continue to observe your religious belief and your wholehearted response to the gift of life, family, and blessings that God has been giving you. Happy birthday ulit, and may God bless you with more birthdays to celebrate on earth. Parating nagmamahal sa inyo, Rick and family. Happy birthday ulit, Mari.
Happy birthday, Tita Ellie! Have a good day, Tita. Take care. Bye!
Happy birthday, Ninang! Thank you for always having our family in your thoughts and always thinking of our kids. We pray that you will have many more happy and healthy years. I hope you enjoy the night. Happy, happy birthday!
Happy birthday, Ninang! I hope you enjoy your day. I wish we can all see each other more often so that we can bond and spend more time with each other. Thank you for, like Kim said, thank you for always keeping us in your prayers, and God bless always. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Ellie!
Happy birthday, Ellie!
Happy birthday, Lola Ellie!
Hello! Greetings from Colorado!
Happy birthday! And many more birthdays to come!
Yeah, we are just wishing you a very beautiful birthday. You are a picture of grace, wisdom, and beauty, and you have lived your life to the fullest. We always enjoy going back to the Philippines knowing that you and Kuya Levi are always there for us. You make our life and our stay in the Philippines a really happy and memorable one because you are always there to give us the warm greetings and hospitality. Say hello to everybody in the family, and I know they are celebrating you as their mom, Kuya Levi's wife, our grandmother. We wish you the very best. We'll see you in January or February.
Okay. Again, happy birthday to you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Happy 80th, Ninang. We miss you, and looking forward to seeing you again, me and Sarah and then the family. Always, you know, cherish when we go to, you know, dinners together at Palms or just anywhere. We wanted to say thank you so much for everything. Thank you for being a great Ninang. And yes, and more than anything, as a person, thank you for making things light and happy and enjoyable, especially when we're at your place. So happiest of birthdays, and wishing you a really great day and amazing memories to share with family. Bye.
Happy birthday, dear Tita Ellie. I didn't realize that you're already 80 since you still look the same as the day Bob first introduced me to you. Anyway, I'd like to say thank you for all those times when you would invite my family to join your gatherings. I really appreciated it, and It was my chance to get close to Bob's relatives. That's why naman, even like now, even if he's not here anymore, I'm still close to you guys. And I really thank you for those times when we were invited. I really hope and pray that you will have more birthdays to come and that you will be blessed with good health. Take care, Tita, and happy birthday again. I love you. Hope to see you soon. Bye.
So we want, Nora and I want to greet you. Happy birthday and also, of course, anniversary. And keep healthy, strong, and taking care of my best friend, your baby Levi. Joke lang, Levi. Ito, boses ni Nora kasi hindi siya nakabihis. But she will wish you too.
Nakapajama pa ako.
just say hi. Mary.
And happy birthday, Ellie.
Okay.
Okay. Hi, Ellie. Here's wishing you the best and happiest on your 80th birthday. May you have more years of this to come. With enjoying the days with your children, grandchildren, and Larry. I hope this greeting will reach you on time. Love you very much. Enjoy your day and celebration.
Thank you again. Happy birthday. I hope you'll always be strong, healthy, and happy. I love you, Ninang Ellie.
Happy, happy, happy birthday, Tita Ellie. Wishing you lots and lots of blessings, of love and happiness for many more years to come.
Ellie, I wish you well. I wish you many, many more years of traveling with Lewi and having a good time with your family. Cheers.
Hi, Tita Ellie. Happy 80th birthday.
Again, Tita Ellie, happy birthday. I hope you enjoyed your 80th birthday with your family and friends.
Happy birthday, Lola Ellie.
And please do take care of yourself. Take care of you and Pops. Your health is very, very important. And make sure that we want to have another 20 years still with you, no? And to hit the centennial. So, happy birthday, Mom. Ciao from Italy. And we will see you soon. And can't wait to be home and celebrate your birthday with you. And I hope you had a great surprise. We prepared this for you. I know this was cut late because we were traveling, but at least we're here now. And hopefully you enjoyed your party today. Happy birthday, Mom.
Happy birthday, Mom. We love you.
Happy birthday, my love, Ellie. I will always say, I love you. Mucho, mucho. Our esteemed guest this afternoon, enjoy this special day of Ellie. Good afternoon, and have a nice day.
It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind.